Hey, welcome back to MapleTronics. This is Levi Wilson, and I'm here today with Chris Gregory. He's a data center engineer, and he will be giving us a Windows 10 preview. So go ahead, Chris.
Hello, my name's Chris, and today we're going to be going over some of the newer security features that are available in Windows 10. By starting, we're going to go into the settings here, and then go into the privacy. And as you can see, it has many different privacy options. You can choose what the apps can access. You can have them choose to have the ability to see your pictures and account information. Same with the advertising. You can turn on smart screen filter to block certain malicious websites where if you try to go to a website and it tries to download something, it automatically stops it. Or even if you manually try to download it, it will block it. There's also other features one of them's two-factor authentication, which would be right here in Other, which I don't have anything installed, but it'd be like, say, a YubiKey or a external device that would use biometrics, like, say, a fingerprint reader, a palm scanner, YubiKey, which is you plug it in. It's like a USB key that has a built-in PIN code that you have to have that attached into the machine, as well as putting in your password just to log into the machine itself. Windows 10 has actually started creating a newer feature for 3D cameras where it actually does a 3D scan of your face, so that way just holding up a simple picture in front of the webcam will not unlock the laptop any longer. It also has the ability to scan retinas as well. So that is one of the new features for the biometric two-factor authentication.
That's a pretty cool feature.
Yeah, it is.
So do you have to have a special camera, or is that a normal webcam?
Yes, that is. They are just coming out onto the market. You do have to have a special camera. They actually have them in some of the Windows phones now. So if you have one of the newer Windows phones, it already has the camera in it.
Oh, that's cool.
And HP already has the camera in some of their newer laptops as well. Dell's getting onto the market with that. They're following up behind, and a lot of the other manufacturers are jumping on the bandwagon for that as well.
Cool.
Some of the other features that are more towards the business side rather than the personal side is Windows 10 has the ability, it's called DLP, and that's data loss protection, where anything that is titled as or marked as a corporate information via a website, email, a document that's created, pictures, anything that has to do with when it's created or used on the network is automatically encrypted and separated from the client's personal data on the laptop. So that way there's no chance of it being stolen or lost. And it does this all in the background without the user actually knowing.
Who's controlling that? Would that be like an IT manager sets it up in conjunction with the server?
Yep.
Okay.
It basically be pushed out from the server.
Okay.
Another thing that they have also for it is it's called Trusted Apps, and it is also another protected system for Windows 10 that's pushed out by the IT management as well. And what that does is it actually goes in and makes it so only certain apps can be downloaded onto the computer by the user. Basically, it is a Microsoft signed app that has been approved by the IT or the management of the network, saying, yes, we will allow this on our machines, and that prevents the average user from just going out to the app store and saying, oh, hey, I want this new game that everyone's talking about, and downloading it onto the computer,
Finding
out it has malware with it.
So that's pretty cool. There's a good element of security and productivity to do that, to have
yes.
that amount of control on that. But what about, say I'm the CEO of the company and I want to download an app, and then I get this pop-up saying you can't download this, you got to get hold of your IT manager. I'm going to find that very annoying. Is there a way around that, or is that just kind of tough?
That's one of the big issues between security IT professionals and CEOs on a daily basis.
that's always going to be there.
Yeah, that's always going to be there.
Okay, cool.
And it's pick your battle.
All right. All right, cool. Well, sounds good. We went over the two-factor authentication, kind of the cool new ways that are being incorporated in Windows 10, the separation of data for personal and corporate, and then the trusted apps. So I think that's some good information, and I just want to say thank you very much, Chris. It's been helpful.
Thank you.
See ya.
You have a great day, Levi.